Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 86, verse number 21 onwards, I think we have to see, 22 onwards. And what has happened till now, in short, is where we left. Tayo prasanno bhagavan daru kena hrutam tartham aruya. Aruya sakam munibihi videhan prayayo prabhu narado vamadevo trihi krishno ramo asito arunihi aham bruhaspati kanvo maitreyash chavanadayaha tatra tatra tamayantam paura janapadan rupa upatastu sardehastha grahai surya mevoditam. When the Lord, because he is all-knowing, all-pervading, functioning through every heart, he knows the intrinsic desire of the king Bahulashwa and the Shrutadev, these two fellows. One is the king of the Videha, ruling from Mithila, and the other is Shrutadev. He is absolutely a poor fellow, a mendicant, living with his wife and family, and living, subsisting only on what nature gives him. Never collecting, never possessing, and there is enough always for him, whatever is the need. And both of them are great devotees of the Lord, and both of them want the darshan of the Lord. They have never seen the Lord. They only heard of him. Many people, when they hear of some Mahatma's name, it's as if some virus goes into them. They start, hey, Mahatma, they are all corrupt, they are all this, they are all that. They have not even met. Not like that. Even if they have not known, and yet, you know, so many cases are there all over the world. Maybe you are one of the cases where you have not met anyone, but that picture of that Mahatma or the mantra of that Mahatma is reverberating in your head, unknowing, by his grace, not because of you, because of his grace. So one must not judge anyone, whether they are a common man or they are our heart must be pure, because that will benefit us. Otherwise, when we look at everyone with an eye of suspicion, it is not corrupting that person, it is corrupting us. And therefore, these two, they have a deep love for the Lord. They know that that infinite Paramatma, who is formless, attributeless, has appeared on earth amongst them at this present moment as Lord Shri Krishna. They have known that, and they are waiting for the grace. We have an example in our house also, who wants darshan of Shirdi Sai Baba. Why does Ganesha not come to me? Why does Shiva not come to me? Many people ask these type of questions. But yeah, it is not question of why they don't come to you. Are you ready to handle if he comes? Are you having the eye to recognize if he has come and gone? Just having a mere wish that I want a darshan of, I want Shirdi Sai Baba to come, and then, you know, my life will be fulfilled. Nothing like that happens. Yes, it is his grace to come, but at the same time, the calling must be from our heart. We must become the patra, the vessel, in which the Lord can pour his grace. And what is that vessel? That vessel is not yoga. It's not the body. It's your mind. The antakaran shuddhi should be there. Antakaran shuddhi should be there. If that is not there, how will, even if Lord is plentifully available, you will not have the vision to access to him, see him, recognize him. This was the problem, I think I told you about Tulsidas ji. Even though studied in scriptures, this, that, everything, yet lost in that, in prayer. Are, aage dekho, kon aa raha hai? Then Hanumanji had to, third time Hanumanji had to prompt him. So in this way, here it is, listening to the Lord's nature is to grace everyone, coming to know that these two great devotees are there waiting for him. He calls all the Rishi Munis, all the names that we took, Naradji, Vamadevji, Atrihi, Dvaipayana Krishna, Rama, Asita, Aruni, and then Shukdevji Maharaj, Brihaspati, Kanva, Maitreya, and Chavana, etc. And there are quite a few of them. All of them, yesterday someone asked me, they said, oh, are these Munis living? I said, yes. Where are they? I said, what are you going to do if where are they? Is it going to help in any way? I also don't know where they are, but they are everywhere. And they grace. Somehow or the other, they grace those who are qualified to have their vision. See? A lot of people are prarambhashur. You know what is prarambhashur? They begin their sadhana with great fervor and energy, but they don't have the staying power. They don't have the staying power. They keep flitting from one idea to another idea to another idea to another idea. Belsare Maharaj, you heard of Belsare Maharaj? I told you the story. When he went to Gondavle, the monkey came and blessed him, and he was married. His house is still there. He's got a Hanuman temple next flat, and he used to give lectures on Bhagavad Gita, and the entire 4 or 5 streets near the railway station were closed. People used to volunteer. No organizing. People are organizing. What are, they put chatai, you know, the dari, all on the road, 1 row, 2 row, 3 row, 4 row. And all of them are sitting very, very disciplined manner. First it was first street, they put the microphone, it was coming. Then the second street, third street, slowly, so many streets, and every morning 1 hour you'll give lecture, every weekend. See? That Belsare Maharaj. Why did this monkey come? Ah, monkey came. It's not monkey, it is Hanumanji. Who can come and grace like that? Or bless like that? One photo I sent you on the WhatsApp. Akkalkot, that monkey langur is sitting in the pose in which Akkalkot Maharaj used to sit. You know, he's sitting like that. That's exactly how Akkalkot Maharaj used to sit and meditate. Now, these are not coincidences, you know. So, here, Bhagwan Shri Krishna, along with all the great Rishi Munis, he starts on the journey to bless these two great devotees. But how is his journey? It is not point A to point B, no. It is going all around. And as he is going around, those people of various countries who have only heard of Sri Krishna, who have only heard of Narad Muni, who have only heard of the various rishis' names, are actually beholding these great masters with their own eyes. And feeling blessed. And there, and who is this Lord? Lord is blessing everyone by his mere vision. People's, what do you call, sins are vanquished once and for all. And they are feeling great bliss. And he went to so many different countries, it was told. And eventually, he went to Anartha, Dhanva, Kuru Jangala, Kanaka, Matsya, Panchala, Kunti, Madhu, Kaikeya, Koshala, Arna, and all various other territories, etc., etc. And eventually, he reached, eventually he reached Videha, where this Bahulashwa is the king. And on his journey, he blessed many people. And now we come to verse number 22. What happens after that? Te chutam praptam akarnya paura janapada nrupa abhiyur muditas tasmai gruhitarhana panayaha drushtvata uttamashlokam प्रीत्युत्फुल्लाननाशयाः कैर्धृतांजलिभिर्नेमुहु श्रुतपूर्वांस्तथा मुनीन् स्वानुग्रहाय संप्राप्तं मन्वानौतं जगद्गुरुं मैथिलश्रुतदेवश्च पादयोपेततुः प्रभोः निमन्त्रयेता दाशार्हम् आतिथ्येन सह द्विजैः मैथिलश्रुतदेवश्च युगपत् महताञ्जली भगवांस्तदभिप्रेत्य द्वयो प्रियचिकीर्षया उभयोराविशद्गेह उभाभ्यां ददलक्षितः श्रोतुमप्यस्सतां दूरान् जनक स्वगृहागतान् आनितेष्वासनाग्रेषु सुखासीनान् महामनाः प्रवृद्धभक्त्या उद्धर्ष हृदयास्त्राविलेक्षणः नत्वा तदङ्घ्रीं प्रक्षाल्य तदपो लोकपावनीः सकुटुम्बो वहन्मूर्ध्ना पूजयाञ्चक्र ईश्वरान् गन्धमाल्याम्बराकल्प धूपदीपार्घ्यगोवृषैः वाचा मधुरया प्रीणान् इदमाहान्नप्तर्पितान् पादावङ्गकतौ विष्णोः संस्पृशन् क्षणकैर्मुदा. Shukdev ji Maharaj is saying, Parikshit, when these two heard of arrival of Shri Krishna, who the Bahulashva and Shrutadev. They were so delighted, and not only them, all the people, they know that their king is a great devotee of Krishna, and Shrutadev, a gem doesn't need to declare itself. Everyone comes to know. A flower doesn't need to declare, I am a flower, I got nectar, please come and take the nectar. It doesn't. Automatically, people pluck it, bees take the nectar. So similarly, Shrutadev is one who is living a very austere life, doing his duties, which is remembering the Lord, and people know about his greatness, that he is a great devotee as well as the king. And all of them came with the offerings in their hands, puja thali, etc., etc., to welcome the Lord. And these two also, at the sight of the Lord, their faces brightened and the buds of their hearts opened through ecstasy. With their heads bent low and with their palms joined on them, they greeted the Lord and his companions, the sages, of whom they had only heard before. See? महात्मा आ गए अपने घर में भी आते हैं ना महात्मा हाँ स्वामी जी नोज एवरीथिंग आते हैं जब महात्मा स्वामी डिफरेंट महात्मा ही नोज एवरीथिंग सो वी टेक हिम फॉर ग्रांटेड एनी महात्मा समवन एल्डर समवन रिस्पेक्टेबल इन सोसाइटी एनी वन हु इज ग्रेटर देन यू इफ दे कम इनटू योर हाउस दे मस्ट बी रिस्पेक्टेड. Oh, but that politician is a crook. Better pray to the crook. Because he's got power. Because if you make him mad, your life is in hell. Understand? So when Mahatmas come, we must, this is the way that we welcome them into our kingdom, into our house, into our hearts. And one must be happy, not feel that, phir se aa gaye, again another year, now we'll have sleepless nights. Theek hai, Upanishads and satsangs is good, but it's so much work, you know. Do you feel that way?
No.
I don't think so. We are all excited.
There's always a big smile for those 2-3 weeks that he's here, isn't it?
And that is the right attitude. That is the right attitude.
And with that attitude, these two and the kingdom, all the people from the kingdom of Mithila, they welcomed. Realizing that Sri Krishna, the teacher of the world, had come to show Swanugrahaya Sampraptam Manvanautam Jagadgurum. That the teacher of Jagat Gurum, the guru of the whole world, he has arrived in our kingdom, in our country. Maithila Shrutadevascha. Maithila is Bahulashva. So, Yugapat Sahatanjali, both of them went there at the same time and prostrated at his feet and invited Shri Krishna to their house. And Shri Krishna said, Tathastu, to both of them.
Now see the
joy, what will happen. So both of them fell at his feet, both of them asked Shri Krishna to come and bless their home and the palace and take food and give Ashirvad. And straight away, Shri Krishna has said yes to both of them. In the 26th verse, he says, Bhagavans tad abhipretya dvayo priya chikirshaya ubhayo ravishadgeham ubhabhyam tad alakshitaha. And if the Lord accepts the invitation of both of them and pleases both of them because they are his devotees, Lord is a servant of all his true devotees. And therefore, he could not say no. You see?
and entered. Having said that, he went with both of them.
Having said that,
here it says, Ubhabhyam tada lakshita, and he went with both of them to their houses. Meaning
that the Lord,
who is the Yogeshwar, who is the master of all the yogis, he made himself into two.
Not only himself,
all the munis and rishis that were with him, all of them became double. One went with Shrutadev,
with Krishna, one group,
and the other group went to Bahulashwa's palace, not knowing that the Lord has gone at the same time to the other fair, to other. And in this way, the first part is being taken of Bahulashwa. Shrotumapyasatam duran janaka swagruhagatan aniteshvasanagreshu sukhasinan mahamanaha. And the Bahulashwa, the king of Videha, he has got all the opulence and all the wealth and all the samagri at his disposal, and with a grand manner he welcomes the Lord into his palace, washes his feet and feels blessed, does the puja, chants all the names, etc., etc., and then gave them the throne to sit down, and his heart leapt for joy through intense devotion. When whom you have been praying all your life, that deity, that person comes in front of you, what will happen to you? You will be out of your, jumping out of your skin, isn't it? Just
some minuscule desire gets
satisfied, we feel so happy. Imagine the Lord himself is standing in front of you.
Don't be like Dhruva.
I will not open my eyes. You have tricked me many times.
You remember?
Because you had to do more sadhana. It's not like here it is.
He is in ecstasy with horripilations on his body and tears flowing through his eyes,
and with this demeanor, with this surrender, with this ecstasy, somehow the Bahulashwa is able to do the puja of the Lord, washing his feet and all that. And then he takes the water and he sprinkles it on his head and his relatives who are there, and all of them offered their prayers to the Lord as well as the sages. And after that, he doesn't stop there, because he's the king. He gives so many things in as dakshina. He offers sandal paste, flowers, clothes, ornaments, scented fumes, lights, oblation of water, cows and oxen, and because he has got all the wealth. And in the end, vacha madhuraya preenan idam ahan natarpitan padavankagatau vishnoho sanspruṣan shanakair mudā. After the Lord and the saints and sages had been fed, Bahulashwa, he took the feet of the Lord and put it in his lap. No permission allowed.
He took the feet,
put them in his lap, and started pressing, massaging, because he knows this person, this Lord who is sitting in front of me, he is Lord Narayana himself. He is none other than Lord Narayana. When we start treating every guest like that in our life, who comes to our house, every Mahatma who comes into our life, we treat him
that way, you will be benefited, not the Mahatma.
You know, there was one movie
of Devanand. He is a thief and he is escaping from the police, and he goes into one village
and he wears the clothes of a sannyasi because he's hiding. And people said, oh, Babaji aa gaye, Babaji aa gaye, Babaji aa gaye. And they start going to him. And he doesn't know what to, he starts giving blessings, and the blessings start coming true. He becomes very famous. And the police come to know. And the police come to know. But by the time police come, I think that's how the story goes, he is a converted man. See? And started gently pressing the feet of the Lord and delighting him with sweet words, he started singing the praises of the Lord. And this is how, whenever you want a blessing from someone, whenever you want something from someone, look at the child, learn from children. Mummy, you are looking very beautiful today. Mummy, aapka khana bahut acha bana hai. A smart mom will say, beta, what do you want after two times? A dumb mom, this fellow, Mummy, I am praising you for so long and you are not asking what do you want. So this puja that we have in our culture, in our Sanskriti, it is for this purpose. Whenever we want something from someone, as a grihasth, as a family person, we always have some need or the other. Even the grace also is the need, it's a desire only, no? Please God, grace me with your union, isn't it? I want to be your ananya, please, 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 please. That's also desire only. But how do your desire get fulfilled? It's an art. First is that you should desire without expectation, without any expectation of a particular result, that it is going to happen this way or that way. Let it unfold. It's a good desire. Even if the worldly desire is there, you want to get married, you want to get a job, place it in your mind, but don't bring about the conclusion in your mind. Leave it to the Lord. He will make it happen.
See?
So, do all that. Now, if he is in front of you, then what do you do? This is what you do. Do the puja, everything. Chant his 108 names. Feed him. Pray, make him relax. And when he is in a happy mood, when he is pleased does God need pleasing from you? No. Then why are you doing all this? Out of the love in your heart. See? So when, you know, you have seen these children, like Bhagyashree's age and all, they play the doll house with much care. They are making the hair of that doll with so much care. They are making the, very nicely they take the hand off and put it again with so much care, then the leg take out and then put it back in, then with so much care they make her sit down or do whatever nicely. And it's almost real when they are making the tea and giving it to that doll or playing that, like that we must do the puja. Not a mechanical thing. Om Shri Krishna Namaha, Asanam Samarpami, Dhar Karke, Akshata Phenk Diya. Uske baad Pushpam Samarpami, Yahan Se Uthaya Aur Wahan Pe Phenk Diya. Aise thoda na puja hoti hai. It has to be an interaction that you are seeing in that Vigraha, the divine expressing at that moment, just like that child knows that this is a doll, but she is taking it to be real. She can't see the chairs, she can't see the dishes, she can't see the tea, but she's imagining in her mind all this is real, and so realistically the dialogues go on and the bhava you can see in that child, isn't it? Like that the puja has to be done. Then see,
kyun nahi aayenge bhagwan, zarur aayenge. If you have been to Shringeri, some of you have gone to Shringeri.
Have you seen the Bharti Tirth ji doing the puja of the Chandra Maulishwara?
He उस समय बाल खड़े हो जाते हैं.
इतने he is totally focused.
And the bhava
on his face. Oh. Like this, yeah.
And by doing this, nobody is going to get benefited, only us.
Idea is that whatever you do in life, don't do it mechanically.
Whatever you do,
do it with deep
love for what you're doing.
Whatever is being done.
Do it as an offering to the Lord.
So if I'm speaking here, it must be as an offering to the Lord.
It must be, I must lovingly, with inspiration, with enthusiasm, express whatever I can.
Not, so one day they came, and tum bhi bhag jaoge, main bhi bhag jaunga after some time.
See?
So same way when you are listening, you have to also interact in the same frame of mind and heart. See? With the joy, with
love for
what is going on at the for the Lord Shri Krishna.
So with this, the feet of the Lord are in his lap.
He is pressing the feet, looking at the Lord up there. And what does King Bahulashwa say?
He says,
Rajovacha Bhavani Sarva Bhutanam Atma Sakshi Swadruk Vibho Adhanastvat Padam Bhojam Smaratam Darshanam Gataha Swavachastadrutam Kartum Asmad Drukgocharo Bhavan यदाथैकांत भक्तान में नानंत श्री रजप्रियः कोनु स्वच्छ नाम भोजम एवं विद विसृजेत पुमान निष्किंचानानां शतानां मुनीनां यस्त्वमात्मदः योवतीर्य यदोर्वंशे नृणाम संसरताम्यह यशो वितेन तच्छान्त्यै त्रैलोक्य वृजिनापहं नमस्तुभ्यं भगवते कृष्णाय कुंठमेधसे नारायणाय ऋषये सुशांतं तप ईयुषे दिनानि कतिचित् भूमन् गृहाणो निवस द्विजैः समेत पादरजसा पुनीहिदं निमेकुलम् इत्युपामन्त्रितो राज्ञा भगवान् लोकभावनः उवास कुर्वन् कल्याणं मिथिलानरयोक्षिताम् भवान् हि सर्वभूतानाम् आत्मा साक्षी स्वदृग् विभो अधनस्त वत पदाम भोजम स्मरताम दर्शनम गतः किंग बहुलश्वा सी अगेन टू थिंक दैट आई एम मेकिंग द प्रेयर ऑफ द लॉर्ड यू नो समटाइम्स वी सी पीपल चैंटिंग दे नो द होल विष्णु सहस्रनाम दे नो द होल हनुमान चालीसा दे नो द होल भगवद गीता दे नो द होल ललिता सहस्रनाम और सो मेनी डिफरेंट श्लोकास एंड I know people who know the entire Bhagavad also by heart. हाँ हमें तो आता है क्या आता है जहाँ हमें तो आता है story gone. Ego is high. See? The words that are coming. What is the third verse that we chant in the beginning?
The Dhruva's prayer.
योन्तः
प्रविश्य मम वाचमिमां प्रसुप्तां सञ्जीवयत्य अखिलशक्ति धरस्वधाम्नाम् अन्याश्च हस्तचरण श्रवणत्वगादीन् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् मीनिंग इट इज द लॉर्ड हु इज फंक्शनिंग थ्रू अवर sense organs. He is the one who is speaking through our mouth. He is the one who is seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, thinking, feeling. Everything is Him. A recognition of this fact that He is the one, I am nothing, is Yonta Parvishya Mama Vacha Mama. Why do we chant it in the beginning? We are making a prayer. Lord, we are reminding ourselves that it is the Lord who is functioning through us. There is no me who is speaking, or there is no me who is listening. You see? Get out of the way. Then see the magic happen. And here, these type of prayers, when can they come? See, whoever wrote Bhagavatam, Satchidananda Rupaya Vishwotpatyadi Hetave, from where did this verse come into the mouth of Shukdevji Maharaj? He has never spoken in his life till he comes to the banks of Gangaji. Isn't it? He has not spoken one word. He has only heard Chatushloki Bhagavat when he was in the womb of his mother from the mouth of the father, who is Vedvyasji. He has heard only the Chatushloki Bhagavat. Or maybe he has heard the thing. But it could have been anything that could have come out of his mouth, isn't it? But what came out? Satchidananda Rupaya Vishwotpatyadi Hetave Tapatraya Vinashaya Shri Krishnaya Vayam Numaha. Same way here, this king, he is having the feet of the Lord in his lap, pressing them gently, caressing them, enjoying the touch, feeling one with the Lord, blessed that I have got the feet of the Lord in my lap. Looks up at the Lord, what can come out of it? You know what will come in our mind? Swamiji, your feet are a bit rough. Swamiji, your feet are a bit soft. They are like makhan. That is pathetic. Attention is on the body. Where is this king's attention? On the Mukharavinda of the Lord. And see what comes out. Bhavan hi sarva bhutanam. Bhavan means, O Lord, you are sarva bhutanam. You are pervading the entire srishti, the entire creation. Sarva bhu, sarva is all, bhuta is space, air, fire, water, earth. All the five elements. That's what this whole creation is made up of. He's saying, you are pervading the entire creation. And how, and you are the Sakshi Swadruk Vibho. And you are the Sak. You are pervading the entire creation, and you are the witness of the entire creation. And so is true about you also. Because He is in your heart. He is not away from your heart. Out of the Lord's Maya, the creation came. This, five elements came, they mixed with each other, the various senses and organs and everything was made, and then the Lord entered after the body was created. And where did He place Himself? In the heart. Heart is not one place. Heart is not one place. And from there, how does He function? As the Sakshi. Are you not the witness of everything in your life? Don't you know that you have lived for 30, 40, 50 years? Don't you know that every day you have been going through, every day you have been going through waking, dream and deep sleep experience? How can you know if you are not the witness? But when it comes to the present moment, no. All that is nice when you say, but actually our experience is I am attached to my husband, wife, children and this world and this body. But the truth is, you can never be attached. This is the problem with which we are living. This is the ignorance. That you are the Sakshi, essentially, but making believe yourself that you are not. And when you start making believe yourself that you are not the eternal witness, that's when the misery begins. That's when the bondage begins. There's nothing wrong with body, breath, mind, intellect to function. But to consider that I'm only this body, mind, intellect, that's where the problem begins. And this is happening because you have forgotten who you are. And who are you? The Atma. And what is another name of Atma? Paramatma. And how has that Paramatma come into this world to remind us? As Lord Krishna. See? Think coolly sometimes. Sit down. Get out of this conundrum that we have created for ourselves. This confusion is only in our mind. In reality, there is no confusion. Only in the mind. Mind means confusion. Mind means confusion. Mind means simple things made complicated. When do you make it uncomplicated? When you go to sleep. Isn't it? Everything becomes uncomplicated because you don't know it. Now, you have to not know it consciously. There it is happening unconsciously. You have to not know it consciously. For that, we come to Bhagavad, we come to the Leelas of the Lord, so that by continuous listening to the Lord, remembering the Lord, listening to His stories, our mind gets intoxicated by the Lord. See, there are different stages. First is
puja.
Puja is karma kanda. If you are doing it correctly, it will lead to manasik puja. I think I told you last week or the week before, manasik puja. If manasik puja is being done with the right intention and love for the Lord, after some time manas puja also will drop away. Then your attention is, I want only Lord. Why I am unnecessarily spending time thinking about asanam samrapayami, dhupam gharapayami, naivedyam nivedayami? Why I need all that? Lord is everything. I want to remember only the Lord. And when you start chanting the name of the Lord, and there also, let's take it this way. Initially, you cannot think of that, as I told in the beginning of the class, you cannot think of the abstract reality. Paramatma is formless and attributeless. How will you think of Him? So you are just a beginner. So you take the form of the Lord and you become focused on Him. And how do you become focused on Him? And you start chanting, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. बीच में शिवजी आ जाते हैं, कभी सरस्वती आ जाती है, प्रॉब्लम. तो यू वी कम टू भागवत, वी लिसन टू द स्टोरीज. इंडियन माइंड इज वेरी ब्लेस्ड. इट इज इट ऑलरेडी नोज दैट ऑल गॉड्स आर वन. नो कन्फ्यूजन दैट दिस होल थिंग इज द ग्लोरी ऑफ द लॉर्ड अलोन. विच लॉर्ड चूज? बट दैट बिकम्स डेट्रीमेंटल ऑल्सो इफ यू आर नॉट फोकस्ड. So if you take one Lord and put all your energy and emotion and love towards that one, knowing that by through Him or through her, you will come to know all of them. Correct or not? When you start doing it, suppose you take Krishna Bhagwan, Lord Krishna is in front of you. You will go into, first one is called, what is the first samadhi called? Drishyanuvit Savikalpa Samadhi. Drishyanuvit means Samadhi with a thought of the form of the Lord. And in that also there are various stages. What is the first stage? First stage is the whole Lord is there with Chaturbhuj. And when you are looking at Him, sometimes the chakra calls you, sometimes the gada calls you, sometimes the lotus calls you, sometimes the Lord winks. And then, ye kya hua? And you feel all the ecstasy and, oh my God, Lord is communicating with me. And you will be in samadhi. But as
if you want to be one with the Lord, again, intention is very important, that you want to merge into the Lord. You are not happy with just looking at Him. You want to become one with Him, that there is no distance between Him and you. If that is your intention, automatically, somewhere after days, weeks, months, depends upon how you are able to fine-tune your mind, the intention should be correct, pure, then automatically your mind will withdraw from the body of the Lord and it will stick to some part. It may stick to the two eyes, it may come and settle at the two lips or the two feet, or on the Shrivatsa, somewhere. Now what has happened? From so many limbs of the Lord, you have come only to the two lips, you have only come to the two feet, you have only come to the two eyes, and you keep looking. That is the next stage in Samadhi. So from many, you have come to two. Now from two, you have to go to one. And you don't know what that one is. Nowhere you know what the one is. Because that one is not separate to you. So when you are looking at those two eyes, it's like a tratak in meditation. And you're looking somewhere, somehow, by the grace, you will get sucked into the third eye of the Lord. If you're looking at the lips, sometimes your attention will go to the upper lip. Yeah, upper lip is more full than the lower lip. So that is also a distraction, isn't it? Two. And your attention is in where the two lips meet. You want to enter into Him. You want to become one with Him. You put attention there. You know there are two, but your attention is where they meet. You know there are two eyes, but your attention is in the middle. You know there are two feet, but your attention is
Between
the two feet.
It will lead to Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Try. It doesn't take long. Drishyanu with Samadhi, these are the stages. It doesn't take long. All you have to do is focus. You have the courage, go. Just now one friend of
his, Manoj, came. And he said, "Hi, what is consciousness?" He was going to ask. He asked me that question yesterday. What is consciousness people talk about? I said, it is that which cannot be known. Today he came bang by door. I was taking shower and reading. Eventually he came. He knew I was going in 10 minutes. I came down. He says, "I want to ask you." I said, "Consciousness is that which cannot be known." How do you know what I'm going to ask? Your face.
Mind can only blah, blah, blah about consciousness. Mind can only go blah, blah, blah about Lord. It can never come to know Lord.
It has to vanish for the Lord to reveal.
When you are looking at
the body of the Lord, Chaturbhuj form, or looking at the lips or feet or eyes, it's still the imagination of the mind. It is not the Lord as He is. You have trained your mind from lifetimes that Lord looks like this. That's why there is an affinity towards that particular form, isn't it? And it's okay. Mind needs some support, so you gave him the support.
But how is the Lord essentially? You cannot create Lord in your image, because I am two-armed and two-legged. Lord is Sahasra Shirsha Purusha, many arms and many legs. Not like that. So we make a different caricature out of the Lord. Four arms, okay, it is more acceptable. Not thousand arms, it cannot. How will he walk, how will he eat, etc., etc. Bhavan hi sarva bhutanam atma sakshi swadrug vibho. You are the soul of all created beings, the witness of all hearts, and self-effulgent. Self-effulgent means there is no light which can illuminate the Lord. There is no light which can illuminate the sun. Sun is self-effulgent.
Is he? Is that statement true?
Sun is self-effulgent?
Huh?
Yes or no? Is sun having its own light? Or is it borrowed from somewhere?
That is what sun is.
Huh?
That's it.
Think out of the box.
The sun, the physical sun, the Adi Bhautik Surya, is illumined by the eyes. The eyes are illumined by the
mind.
Mind is illumined by the
Atma or consciousness. So that consciousness, so here we are giving just example, just at the physical level, just like the sun does not require any other light to illumine itself, it is self-illumined, same way this Atma, this Lord, this Paramatma is also self-effulgent. See?
And in this way, you have presently revealed yourself to us who have been constantly contemplating on your lotus feet. Swing. Svavachastadrutam kartum asmad druggocharo bhavan yadathaikanta bhaktan me nananta shri rajah priyah. He says, O Lord, you have appeared before us just in order to vindicate that statement of yours which you have often declared, which is that neither Shri Balrama, who is your second self, nor your better half, Lakshmi, the goddess of beauty and prosperity, nor even your child, Brahma, are dear to you than one who is exclusively devoted to you, the one who is your Ananya Bhakt. You are his more than your brother, your wife, your child. So in other words, Bahulashwa is saying, please shower your grace upon me. I am that Ananya Bhakta. I am your devotee. And maybe that is the reason you have come into my life and come to bless me in my home, allowing me to keep your feet in my own lap, allowing me to speak. In fact, you alone are doing all that. That is his disposition. In the 32nd verse he says, 33rd, ko nu tvacharanam bhojam evam vidavisrujet puman nishkinchananam shantanam muninam yastvamatmadaha. He says that, is there any man on earth who can abandon, who can go away, who cannot be surrendered to you after having seen you or the great saints and sages? He must be a... And there were people like that, isn't it? Shishupal was there, Duryodhan was there, Dhritarashtra was there, Dhritarashtra's wife Gandhari was there, Dantavakra was there, so many, Poundrak was there, so many were there. Yes, that's a different matter, that Lord, by killing them, made them one with him. But the fact was that they saw him, they were in company with him, but they never felt the attitude of surrender or greatness towards him, isn't it? It was a relationship of animosity and hatred. And these sages who are of serene mind, who regard nothing as their own, not even their body, after having
beheld these great Mahatmas who have renounced everything with our own eyes. Will anyone abandon these Mahatmas? Will anyone not surrender to these Mahatmas and yourself? It's a question that he is putting. So therefore he says, Hail to you, O mighty Lord. Here it says, Appearing in the race of Yadu, you have extended your glory, which is capable of wiping out the sins of all the three worlds in order to put an end to the transmigration of men revolving on the whirligig of births and deaths. Here when he says, how do we get births, reincarnation? Why do we get reincarnation? It's a theory, but why do we get it? Why are we born again and again?
Past life impressions.
How did they come about in the first place? Huh? So, desires are already there. Desires are subconscious impressions manifesting in the form of a thought are called desires. Okay? Subconscious impressions, in other word, technical word is vasanas, manifesting in mind when they become thoughts, that is called a desire. Only when it manifests, then you know you have a desire, isn't it? Till it is subconscious, you don't know it is there. My question is, how did they come in the first place? How did you start collecting them? Or how are you collecting them right now? That's very simplistic. Explain. I'm asking question. Test.
Because of ignorance.
Ignorance of what? Ignorance of ignorance.
Not knowing.
Ignorance of the self, ignorance of the Lord makes what happen?
Because we feel incomplete.
Yes, because we make it more realistic. Make it more realistic. So we are ignorant of the Lord or the self, the Sakshi, and therefore we feel, we imagine that we are incomplete. We imagine. It is not the truth. But the moment you forget the divine within you, as you, something happens. What is that? The mind comes into play. That very moment, the mind comes into play. And what is the function of the mind? It is functioning through the senses, isn't it? So two things happen. Either it pops up the desires from wherever, or it gets attached and creates desire. Two ways, isn't it? That is also okay. Because you have got this life, what can you do about it? Why have you got this life? To empty all your desires. Because once the desires are all empty from your mind, you will be one with the Lord automatically. You don't have to do it. So this human birth is an opportunity. If you go with nature, naturally, automatically your mind will become empty. But we don't do that. We don't flow with life. We create friction with life by getting attached. Because see, our intrinsic nature is love. Our intrinsic nature is completeness. The Lord in our heart is complete. Now, that is our nature. But now we have forgotten that is our nature. But we are still complete. But now where we are seeking completeness? Not from the self. From the outside. And that leads to karma. That makes you, it prompts you to act. acting is also okay, desiring is also okay. Act, because if the hunger is there, you will go towards the kitchen. There is no question of attachment there, isn't it? If you are walking on the road and a thorn comes and pricks you, automatically you will react. There is no thinking, there is no question of vasana there. It's a spontaneous, instinctive reaction. See? If we live like that, no problem. But we somewhere lose the plot and we start becoming the doer and we start becoming the enjoyer. We forget that all activities are done. If you remain, let the desires come, they are in the mind, I got nothing to do with it. Who? I'm talking about human being only. You are a seeker. I am a seeker.
As a single cell amoeba, whatever. It's an evolution.
After. If you believe, yes. Forget about amoeba and all that. You are here, no? Right now, what do you choose? To become again amoeba? You have reached the epitome of creation, a human being.
No, the question is, where does it start first?
That's not a question. That's not a question. Ignorance is beginningless, remember. So there's no answer to that. And the way you can find out is right here and now by being subjective. You can't go into the past and work it out. And there are yogis who do it. Huh? Remember one example, it comes in Gondole Maharaj Pothi. He went to Naimisharanya and there he went into a cave, into the earth, and he went in there and one yogi was sitting with huge jatas and all. Photograph is there in the Pothi. And he is sitting there and one devotee said, I am going to come with you. You told me, promised me that I can come with you. I will also come. Gondavlekarji Maharaj went into the mountain through the rock. This fellow is screaming out, I'm afraid, please help me, help me, help me, Gondavle Maharaj, 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 take me with you. He comes, touches his third eye, he's also able to walk into the... The moment they go in huge cave, this yogi is sitting there. Remember? Forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
And when he's sitting there, Gondavle Maharaj goes and shakes him. He doesn't get up. So Gondavle Maharaj sits down. And mentally, he's a great master. He introduces a thought in the mind of the yogi. And that yogi wakes up. He says, I can smell human here. Because that other fellow is there, impure fellow, the devotee. So Gondavle Maharaj says, don't worry about him. Second question. First question, I can smell human. Second question, has Ram taken birth? Gondavlekar Maharaj said, we are in Treta Yug. He took birth in, we are in Kali Yug. He took birth in Treta Yug. He says, again I missed him. Again I missed him. Which means he is still continuing. He wants an objective experience of the divine. And Gondavlekar Maharaj says, don't worry. I'll give you darshan of the Lord here and now. He goes and touches his third eye. He has the darshan. He feels fulfilled. And there, at that very moment, the entire body falls into ashes. Yogagni. Like Shabri, she did the same thing. When she had the darshan of Ramchandraji, he said, ask me what you want. She says, I don't want anything. I got everything. My life is fulfilled. I'm one with you. That was my goal was. Navavidha Bhakti is there. Huh? After when she hears Navavidha Bhakti, what was the conclusion? There and there, she's so old. But there and then, the whole body falls into ashes. So where did it all begin? It began. And the only way you can catch where it began is in this moment, in the now. There is no past, there is no future. They are only imaginations of your mind. It's only in the present moment. Are you aware of yourself or are you not aware of yourself? Are you thinking of the Lord or the divinity, or are you being the divinity? If you are thinking of the divinity, you are under the clutches of ignorance. If you are being the divinity, this question will not come in your mind. The doubt will not be there. Till the doubt is there, think of the divinity just like you think of the sleep and merge. Allow yourself to be sucked into him, sucked into yourself, sucked into the divine. So where have all the sins come from? Sin means here, forget about vasanas and this, that. Sin only means every thought that takes you away from you being the divine or being with the Lord. Every thought that takes you away keeps you separated from who you essentially are. That is at one with the Lord, at one with the Atma. Every thought, if it is the Lord, the name Ram, which is keeping you away from Ram, drop it. Take the name Ram and sit in silence. Take the name Shiva and sit in silence. Allow him to reveal as he is, not as a thought. That thought was like an arrow. You have shot your mind in a direction. Now wait. And in this way, O Lord, you have come in this world, in the Yaduvansh, to remove to absolve the transmigration of all the beings by blessing them. In the 35th verse, he says, Namastubhyam Bhagavate Krishnaya Kuntamedhase Narayanaya Rishaye Sushantam Tapaiyushe. He says, hail to you, O Almighty Sri Krishna, of unrestricted wisdom, who have taken to austerities in the mildest form in the person of the divine sage Narayana. See, what is the tapasya? What is our tapasya? What is tapasya? First thing. What is tap?
Which is not pata.
Okay, which is not pata. So, pata means fall, tapa means rise. What is tapasya? Yes, cassette recorder also focuses on one thing. Same, om, om, om. So is he doing tapa? Is tape recorder doing tapa? No. So what is missing there?
It's consciousness.
Huh?
It's conscious.
So, put it in words. Tapas is, say?
Union with.
No. Tapas is not union. It will lead to that, but it is not union.
Focusing on one thought.
That is dharana. Yes.
One important point is there,
which you are missing.
By your own free will.
Nobody has imposed it on you.
By your own free will.
Self-accepted. Austerity, self-accepted hardship is tapas.
You are not doing upvas so that you can eat sabudana vada. That is not tapasya. But if you are joyfully, willingly doing the Navaratri for 9 days without complaint, you are taking that, oh, it will be a good time to stop thinking about food and remember the Lord, tapasya. So, by your own free will, you are accepting the hardships, That is tapasya. Now, what is your tapasya? Now, come out of the definition of tapasya. What is your tapasya as a human being? To realize that you are the divine. What is tapasya of the Lord? So you want to give up individuality and become one with the total, right? You want to become one with that ekameva dvitiya, isn't it? What is the tapasya of Ishvara? To give up his oneness and become the many. That is his tapasya. That is why he has taken birth in the Yaduvansh. That is why he is multiplying himself into two, to go to Bahurashva and to go to Shrutadev also. That is his tapasya, to fulfill the desires of the devotees. And what is the desire of the devotee? To become one with the Lord. Only those devotees he goes to. See? See how beautiful, this is Leela.
How does he do that?
You're gone in the wrong, go somewhere else.
This is his tapasya. Give up his oneness
and express as many.
And what will happen when he expresses
as many? So he himself is the Lord, he himself is the saints and sages, he himself is the Shrutadev, he himself is the Bahulashva, he is himself the gopis, he himself has become everything.
When he interacts with himself, more joy. The example of this is the ocean. Why does ocean have waves on it? To play with itself. The Lord is playing with himself. If we have this vision, it will help us.
So here he is saying,
and you
have given up your oneness to appear on the earth as Narayana and meditating for the blessings of all humanity. And where is the Lord Narayana meditating? He became Nara and Narayana at Badrinath, the mountain on which the Badrinarayan temple is there, that is called Narayan Parvat. Across the Alaknanda, the mountain is called Nara Parvat. Both of them are meditating for the benefit of humanity.
Why the Lord needs to do it?
It's his story. For the...
That is the Leela.
No, why? So Lord gives up his Vaikuntha to come down on earth for the benefit of human beings. Then what should be the duty of human beings?
To give up all attachment to the world and become one with the Lord. And what will happen because of that?
There will be one less problematic person on this planet.
That's what will happen.
One less person coming and complaining all the time. Isn't it?
So in this way, O Parikshit,
he says, be pleased to stay in our house. Here in the last verse, he says, be pleased to stay in our house, O Lord, for some days along with the sages, and purify this line of Nimi with the dust of your feet. And the Lord agrees, stays there.
Requested thus
by the king, Shri Krishna, the protector of the world, stayed on at Mithila in order to confer blessings on the men and women of the place.
Now this is one side of the story.
Now the other one is Shrutadev. What happens there? Shrutadevo chutam praptam swagruhanjanako yatha natva munin sanghrishto drunvanvaso nanartaha trunapita brusi shvetan aniteshu paveshyasaha swagate nabhinandyangrin sabharyo vanije muda tadambhasa mahabhaga atmanam sagruhan vayam srapayan chakra uddharsho labdha sarva manorathaha falarhano shira shiva mrutambubihi
मृदासुरभ्यातुलसी कुशाम्बुजैः आराधयामास यथोपपन्नया सपर्यया सत्त्वविवर्धनदशा सतर्कयामास कुतो मम वभूद् गृहान्धकूपे पतितस्य सङ्गमः यः सर्वतीर्थास्पदपादरेणुभिः कृष्णेन चास्यात्मनिकेतभूसुरैः सुप्रविष्टान् कृतातिथ्यान् श्रुतदेव उपस्थितः सभार्यस्वजनापत्य उवाचाङ्घ्रयभिमर्शनः Shukdev ji is saying, dear Parikshit, this king of Videha, Shrutadeva was overjoyed to find, first it was Bahulashwa who was the king, but Shrutadev is also being addressed as the king.
Why? A Brahman is not less than a king. The king, he has become, maybe because of, he is born to a father who was a king, or he has conquered the kingdom and become a king, or he has been selected by the people and then he has become a king. But Brahmana, a Brahmin, he is also a king. Why? Because he has given up everything and lived his life only in dedication to the Lord. So his power is greater than a king, really speaking. And therefore he is addressed as a king. Like the king of Videha, Shrutadeva was overjoyed to find Sri Krishna, the immortal Lord, and the sages arrive at his door, and bowing to them, he began to dance, waving his cloth. So the tradition goes. Hey, no elaborate welcome, no. He saw, Nand ke Anand bhai ho jaye Kanhaiya Lal ki. Dancing shuru. Ecstasy. Joy. मेरे तो गिरिधर गोपाल दूसरा ना कोई देखो
bringing seats made of straw and mattresses of kusha grass there the king gave them all the thrones to sit down here he is just putting kusha grass on the ground and he is making them sit down all the lord and all the rishis and munis
and then
from inside and where did he bring all this from his cottage and he borrowed from other people who were living around I guess everyone gave and then he requested the guests to sit on them and greeted them with words of welcome he gladly washed their feet along with his wife. There what happened? The king did all by himself.
So grihastha life,
not only you should love your wife, but the wife must also take part in all the pious activities, in
upasana,
in jap, tap, etc. It should be sahabhagini, not only for loving, but also in other activities. And what is the purpose of life? Not only loving, purpose of life is to perfect yourself.
Merge yourself into the divine.
And when it is done together, it is much more beautiful. Otherwise,
aajkal ka kya hai? Wife does her own things, husband does her own thing, children go into their room and do their own thing. Kuch pata hi nahi kaun kiska wo.
Family heavy ke nahi hai, pata nahi.
Hai na? So have a small house, not too many rooms. You're forced to meet
at the dining table every day.
No choice.
So
he washed the feet of the Lord and then took that water, sprinkled on his wife and himself and all the relatives that were there. He did not feel that only I should be blessed, but blessed everyone who was there, his extended family, his neighbors, this sab, the joy of it. And with that water, he the highly blessed Brahmana sprinkled himself as well as his house and his people and felt that all his objects had been achieved. He was literally transported with joy. So there is nothing more to be achieved by Shrutadevji. That was the ultimate. See, with Dhruva also got darshan of the Lord Narayana, but he did not have this type of bhava, isn't it? He did not have. After having darshan of the Lord, what did he ask from the Lord? The Lord said, what do you want? He said, you know what I want. Are Baba, open your mouth and ask. The Lord knows what he want, what was the reason he came to do tapasya. That was to sit in the lap of the Lord, of the Father. So now he has become the Father. He said, I'll make you sit in my lap permanently, Dhruvatara. But after that, he still continued, because the tribals killed his brother. He was angry and he killed. A devotee cannot kill. He loves unconditionally. He sacrifices unconditionally. And Naradji had to remind Dhruva, Re, you are, everyone knows you are the devotee of the Lord. Lord gave you the darshan and you are committing such act for that one person who killed your brother. You are annihilating the entire tribe. Does that suit you? He stops. Because the intention with which he called the Lord was not pure. The intention, the surrender, the interaction that Shrutadev is having with the Lord is of a different caliber. The antakaran is absolutely purified. Their antakaran was not purified. Therefore such acts were taking place. See? So, and where do you up? Do you need to sit specially to purify your antakaran? No. Whatever you are seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, thinking, doing, enjoying, whatever, all the time have this feeling, the Lord, offer it to the Lord. That's all. Get out of the way. See how quickly the purification will take place? But we, no. Main. Bakre bane hue sabke sab. Bali chadegi. Bali chadegi. This is what the one of the religions, they have this jihad. That jihad is what? Jihad is sacrificing the I on the altar of Allah. But instead, they sacrifice everyone else at the altar because they can go to heaven. It is that jihad is with yourself, not with the community outside. And this I have read from a Muslim fellow only. Then he propitiated with whatever articles of worship could be procured, fruits and other offerings, sandal paste, flowers, incense, cool scented and sweet water, scented earth, and tulsi leaves, kusha grass and lotuses, as well as with food which promotes the quality. So that king, he had everything at his disposal, and his Shrutadev, whatever he could get. Phool nahi hai, patte chalenge. Patte nahi hai, mitti chalegi. Like that. Because the bhava was pure. When they are caught up, no, I need only red flower. Are? Hum
कभी कभी हम पूजा में करते हैं ना,
आई नीड ओनली रेड फ्लावर, इफ वन दुर्वा इज लेस, नो नो नो, पापम पापम, वॉट पापम, गेट आउट ऑफ दैट. दैट इज ओनली हैपनिंग, दीज टाइप ऑफ थॉट्स कम इन पूजा ओनली बिकॉज द आई इज वेरी स्ट्रांग. If I is not there, you are interacting with the divine, then whatever comes by the grace. Important thing is, I must surrender. I must vanish while the puja is going on. My grandfather, I told you, know, three times, he, every morning he will do three or four, at 86 years old.
He used to do three or four Surya Namaskar.
Somehow he used to do it and then he used to sit down in front of the heater.
And he will chant three ohms.
Before the third ohm is chanted completely, he is gone. Vanished. Like a stone used to sit there. And we are doing puja for so many days, doing japa for so many days, chanting Vishnu Sahasranam for so many days, still nothing is happening. Why? The bhav behind what is being chanted, that is not.
Align yourself. Don't do it mechanically. Don't do it.
I left only half the way. Man, you vanished. It's good. But I must complete. Then I is still strong. It must happen by itself, no doubt. But more important should be with what frame of mind and heart you are doing the chanting or the japa or the puja. If I do that
type of feeling while talking,
what will happen? We will stop. Then
there will be no satsang. It will be silent satsang.
So here the purpose is different in a satsang.
See?
I have to communicate. But when you are in your own
private, and there are Mahatmas,
sometimes they cannot,
when they are giving a satsang, they sit, they don't care.
He reflected, what did he say in the 42nd verse? He says, Satarkayamasa kuto mamanva bhud moha गृहांधकूपे पतितस्य संगमः य सर्वतीर्थास्पदपादरेणुभिः कृष्णेन चास्यात्मनिकेत भूसुरैः. He says what? He is wondering while he is doing the puja. He has done the puja. He is wondering how this meeting has become possible for me. I am lost in grihastashram, in my duties, this, that, and doing everything. And yet the Lord has come and graced me. How has this miracle happened? He is thanking his stars. He is thanking the Lord for this miracle too, that this miracle has happened. He says, how this meeting has been possible for me, condemned as I am to this selfish life of a householder with Sri Krishna and the sages who have enthroned him in their hearts, nay, the very dust of whose feet bring sanctity to all holy places. If
Mahatmas, saints
and sages, if they got the darshan of Shri Krishna, it is understandable. They have renounced the life, they have focused on him, they have meditated on him for many, many lifetimes.
Throughout their life.
But me, I am doing my duties. आज सब्जी खरीदो, कल दाल खरीदो, फिर दूध खरीदो, ब्रेड खरीदो,
ये साफ करो, वो साफ करो, गार्डनिंग करो,
बीवी के ताने सुनो, कितनी चीजें होती हैं गृहस्थ में,
है ना. एवरीथिंग इज नॉट
हंकी डोरी ऑल द टाइम. अप्स एंड डाउन्स आर देयर. यू गेट डिस्टर्ब्ड, यू डोंट वांट टू बी डिस्टर्ब्ड, येट यू गेट
डिस्टर्ब्ड.
You are not able to focus.
Yet, the Lord has come and given him darshan.
So something he must have been doing right. And what was that? See, when we do our life, live our life, are we doing actions? Can you live without doing actions? No. So which actions you should do? Desire prompted activity, or depending upon the varnashram that you are living in, varna ashram. So he is a Brahmin and he is a grahastha. According to varna and ashram, whatever karma is required to be done, you must do it. Then there is no question of desire there. Understand? Samajh aa raha hai? Because if you run away from that duty, then you are creating problem in your mind. See? Vashishtha Rishi, who was he? He is a Karmakandi, isn't he? All Rishis, most of the Rishis, they were married, they had children, isn't it? They were living according to their Varna and Ashram. Yet they perfected themselves. Because they did not have, they did not perform actions to fulfill their desires. They performed actions that were enjoined on them based upon their varna and ashram. You see? Then there is no sin. And when those activities, whatever actions you are doing, if that is offered at the feet of the Lord continuously, purification of antakaran has to take place. There is no choice for the Lord but to purify you. So in this way, the Shrutadevji is thinking, when the guest had taken, partaken the hospitality and were comfortably seated, Shrutadeva, along with his wife, children and other relations, waited on them and touching the feet of Shri Krishna, addressed them. He also says a few prayers. Kya time ho gaya? Time kya hai? 8:15. We'll just few verses and then this thought is over. Shrutadeva uvacha, nadyano darshanam praptah paramparam purushah yarhidam shakti bhisrushtva pravishto yatma sattaya yathashayana purusho manasaivatma mayaya srushtva lokam param swapnam anuvishya bhavabhasate shunvatam gadatam shashvad archatam stvabhivandatam nrunam samvadatam antah hrudi bhasyam alatmanam hrudistopyati durastah karma vikshipta chetasam atma shakti bhiragrahyo grahyopi again atma shakti bhiragrahyopi antyupeta gunatmanam namostu te dhyatma vida paratmane anatmane svatma bhivakta mrityave sakarana karana lingamiyushe swamayaya samvrita ruddha drishtaye. Shrutadevji is saying, sattvam shadi swabhrutyanna kim deva karavamahe etadanto nunam klesho yad bhavana kshigocharaha. Shrutadevji says, you are the supreme person beyond Prakriti and the Jivas. It is not for the first time that you have come to our view today, for you have been with us since the very beginning of creation, when having created the universe with the help of your potencies, you entered it as its soul, even as a sleeping person creates with his mind itself a particular dream world of his own through his ignorance, and entering that world himself appears in various forms. This is a very, very beautiful analogy of how the Lord creates the creation and then enters the creation, just like you create the dream creation when you go to sleep, and then you enter the entire dream objects and beings. None of the dream objects and beings have come from outside. Your mind itself has become everyone. The space, air, fire, water, earth, animals, rivers, mountains, the wind, the breathing, the people who are there in the dream, they are thinking, they are speaking, they are hungry, whatever is going on, everything is nothing but your mind. All objects are inert, all people are inert, but why that movement is taking place, why life is expressing in the dream? Because you are the life principle who has entered into every being and creature and object. Exactly the same way, the Lord, the Ishvara, with his Shakti, the Maya Shakti expresses. When it starts expressing, the first expression is Sattva, Rajas, Tamas. With the Tamas comes space, air, fire, water, earth. With the Rajas comes the Indriyas. With the Sattva comes the Antakaran. And then once the body is ready, he enters. One body or many bodies, it does not matter. Just like in the another example, just like according to Bhagavatam, at the zygote, the sperm attaches to the egg, life, the multiplication of the cells begin. There is no life in it. The life is just borrowed life from mother. And the multiplication begins. It becomes a zygote. Zygote grows from a single cell. Slowly, slowly it becomes a serpent. From serpent it becomes a like a frog. From a frog it becomes like a tortoise. From tortoise it becomes a... you start seeing the hands, legs, mouth, everything comes in. And around fifth month, the life, between fifth and the seventh month of pregnancy, the life enters, an independent life. Till then, it was depending upon mother. But after that, it is an independent life. So, first the body came about, because of whatever, multiplication, prakriti, and then the life enter. Now, so imagine, when this body dies, something will leave this body, isn't it? Then, does that something leave this body only from one place, or from every cell in this body? Every cell. How many cells are there? Zillions, zillions, zillions. Isn't it? But when that life enters, at the same time, every cell in your body gets invigorated, isn't it? Activated. And when it leaves, push, spontaneously, in one go. When the dream comes, when the dream begins, you don't first see dead bodies and dead objects. No, suddenly the dream is alive. Because you are there. Because you are there. The whole waking world is also exactly the same. It is a projection in your mind. Don't take it to be too real. Take only the Lord real. This recognition is being narrated by the Shrutadevji to Lord Krishna, as if Lord doesn't know. He knows. But when you are in front of the Lord, wise words automatically come out by His grace. You shine in the heart of those men who constantly hear and repeat your stories, worship and bow to your images, and talk with one another about you and have their heart purified thereby. When the sole theme of your life is Krishna Arpanamastu, Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama, Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. You know, mothers even if their children are 60-year-old, they still, you know, my baby, my, you know, when that child was so young, when my son was so young, my daughter was so young, and they keep telling this, that, अरे यार उसकी जगह पे कृष्ण का नाम ले लो. Instead of that, tell, recount the stories of Krishna. How long will you keep spending time reveling in your children, grandchildren, husband, wife, your house, your car, this, blah, 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 blah. No end to it. So many have done that. What has happened to them? They have died ignorant. You want to die ignorant? Then you can follow. But if you are sincere that you want, and it is possible, every Mahatma is saying it, every saint, Rishi and Muni is saying it, Lord is saying him, saying again and again and again, the Vedas are saying it again and again through various Upanishads, that one lifetime is enough. One moment is enough if you are available. Don't think, nahi yaar, abhi to hard, now I'm already 60, I think next life. Let me enjoy the last 20 years. No. No. Look at Prabhupada. At age of 60, he was doing whatever, you know, due to household duties, etc. But age of 60, it clicked. Left his wife, left his child, went away, came to, there is a Hanuman Mandir opposite Lal Killa in Delhi. Sat there, started writing commentary on Bhagavad Gita. And chanting the label. Something caught him from inside. Even if it came at 60. It's worth it, no? What a movement he left behind. And it's not a question of what he left behind. He was satisfied. He was contented that every moment of my life, it is his glory. And he sang and danced and affected, and automatically it got, the society got affected by it, isn't it? Who is getting affected by our presence? Even the rat looks at you, he runs away. Aa gaya marne ke liye. Cockroach, ar bhago. Morty leke koi aa raha hai. Think, there is much more to life, as Shrutadeva is expressing. Don't live a desire-oriented life, live a duty-oriented life, and that duty is according to your varna and ashram. Then there is no sin incurred. You will expiate all your sins. Automatically, antakaran shuddhi will come up. As long as all those activities are offered at the feet of the Lord. That means Lord is the main theme, activity is secondary. Though present in their heart, you are remote from those whose mind is distracted by activities of various and various kinds in temporal duties. Though beyond the grasp of various faculties of mind, you are very close to those who have developed the excellent quality of their heart by singing and hearing your glories. My salutations be to you who are the Supreme Spirit in the eyes of those who know the Self, whereas before those who regard themselves as the body, etc., as their Self, you appear to them as death and death alone. So those who remember the Lord, those who remember, recognize that they are none other than a part of that divine, for them salvation is possible. But if you hold on insisting that I am only this body, that I am only this mind, that I am a product of my parents, that one day I'm going to die, then the only thing that the Lord will appear to you, not as the Lord, he'll appear as the Lord of death, because he alone is all the gods. So he appears, and Lord or death instills fear in a person who is dying. You remember the story of Ajamil. And therefore, you are the ruler of all effects as well as of their cause. Your Maya cannot screen your vision, though it screens the vision of others. So, what is the difference between the Lord and us? We are slaves of our mind. Lord is the master of his mind. We are the slaves of our prakriti. Lord is the master of his prakriti. What is his prakriti? Maya Shakti. How is Maya Shakti expressing at the individual level? As the mind, Mana Shakti. I just went to Mansarovar, I dipped in it and came out. So what is the journey of an individual? From being a slave of the mind to becoming the master of the mind. And that mastery is not with willpower. It has to be gained through surrender and grace. That's the journey. And those who think that Ravana was one, he was a master of the three worlds. With willpower he controlled himself, body, breath, mind, intellect. Made his individual intellect into the total intellect. That's why he was able to control the three worlds. But still he could not control the prakriti. In the end he had to die because he wanted to become immortal with body. Not possible. You can last for some time. But eventually nature will balance itself out. Lord will make sure that the balance comes about. Otherwise such people, they only spread atrocity. Because he killed, he looted, he spoiled their sacrifices. And in this way, self-effulgent Lord, instruct us, your servants, what service we should render to you. The sufferings of men disappear as soon as you come to their view. And what is the instruction of the Lord? We will see in our next class. And in this way, the two great devotees of the Lord got the darshan of the Lord, the blessings of the Lord simultaneously. And both of them are going to achieve salvation. And we will see what the Lord's instructions are to Shrutadev. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.